Hello friends, hi and welcome to Insights with me, Shirish. The other day I was attending a function and I met two of our mothers who were really worried about their child for the changed behavior in the child. When we discussed about what exactly the behavior is, she told me something which I could relate to the age factor of the child. When the child attends in a teenage, there are many changes that take place in the child's maybe thought process, maybe his understanding, or the way he is growing up. We as a parent sometimes fail to understand it, and we take the blame on ourselves if we are not doing the right type of parenting. So today's video is basically for those parents whose child is just about to be in a teenage or is in a teenage and they are worried about their changed behavior. So stay tuned and let us discuss how we can cope up with the teenager child's mind. My name is Shirish and you're watching Insights with me, Shirish. When a child attains a teenage, the first and the very important change that takes place in the child is the child understands things much better than he earlier understood. The child thinks he is growing up now and he has his own opinions, likes and dislikes. Whenever you would be advising him for something or forcing him to buy something, he would never agree on it because now he would have his own choice. So the first thing that a parent need to do, that instead of blaming yourself or thinking if you are doing the right parenting, you need to accept the child with the changes that has happened to him. Like you and me who have been through the teenage earlier, many other parents are facing the same problem. When we were in teenage, somewhere we also thought that our parents are not understanding us. And probably your child is also thinking the same. So give him his space and let him take some small decisions on his own. In this way, the child will feel independent and confident. Second thing is, when you're suggesting anything to your child, you see that you're not ordering the child. Do not advise many things to him. You put forth things in front of him in such a way that he would come up with a solution and ultimately it becomes his commitment. The one positive thing with the children who are in teenage is they strongly believe in something they do. So, if you want your child to do something, for example, if you're looking up for your child studying every day and you want him to study at least for 2 hours. So instead of telling him how many hours he should study or what time he should study, you can put forth a question saying, what do you think, when would be the right time for you to study? Would you like to study in the morning or in the evening? And what do you think, 1 or 2 hours, what would be the suitable time for you to study? The child may end up saying 1 hour, but the best part is that he would commit that 1 hour to you. He would commit that time to you, maybe early in the morning or maybe in the evening. So once he commits that, because he has committed, the child fulfills it. So do not go and advise the child for anything. Third, in this age, children like to go for new adventures. They like to explore the world. Till they have attained teenage, we as a parent have always supported them. We have always taken care of them and always took them below our wings as and when required. But now when the child realizes that he is grown up, he wants to explore the world. He wants to try new things. You must have observed that the children who are in teenage, they love to ride the bikes. They love to watch action movies. They love to play games wherein there is some action. They like to do some events like racing or something which is related to action. In this course, it may happen that the child may be in a bad company or may try something which he should not. So, as a parent, what you can do is, you can let him participate in some sports which are equal to adventure for him, like swimming or maybe football or any ground game where he loves to play and he feels a sort of adventure. If you think your child is not that capable of leaving him alone, you can have small adventures at home. Like you can play games with him, you can accompany him for swimming or any other sport, you can do racing with him. You can start with a normal racing, then you can start with the bicycle racing, or you can even plan an adventure tour. Now this adventure tour is not essentially a big adventure. It can be anything like going on a long drive or checking out some place which you have never gone to, or just going for a trekking, or something like going on a different road which you have never taken. Apart from this, trying any sport with the child, playing any game with the child, making him win also makes him feel being a bit adventurous. So, as a parent, if you accompany the child for any such games, the child would not go around in search of adventure or a person to accompany him. Next is, advising the child at times becomes difficult. The children get angry and irritated. They may also become adamant and they may reply sometimes in an arrogant way. In order to avoid this, if you feel that the child is denying to something just because you are saying it, you need to find out a way, you need to find out somebody to whom the child is looking up to. If you have grandparents in the family and child is very fond of them, if any of the teacher to whom the child listens, or any of his best friend's mother or your neighbor or auntie to whom the child listens to, you can catch hold of such person and get the things done from that person. In the beginning, you may feel bad because you will have to take someone's help for your own child. But that is the beginning and the child would be doing things as you want. Example, if your child is not studying and you want him to study, then you can ask his grandparents to ask him to study or sit with him for study, or even like we have a play date, you can have a study date with the neighborhood child, or his teacher can also encourage him studying. In such a way, the child will do something that you want to do. But if you are advising him or suggesting him, the child will adamantly not do it just because he wants to go against what you are saying. As I told you, 2 days back I had been to a function where the mothers were really worried because their children were not ready to come with them for any social gathering. This is one of the things that the teenager child prefers. They prefer to go on their own. They do not always like to accompany their parents everywhere. They want to feel grown up and big. So, it is okay if the child is not coming up with you. It is okay if he is bit to accept it that sometimes child may behave like this. But if you take it calmly and with patience, this time will also pass. We need to accept that somewhere in teenage, every child behaves in this way. Probably you also in your teenage must have behaved in this way. If we look back, there are many well-known people who have suffered from this. We have a best example of Mahatma Gandhi, whom we call father of the nation. But his children never accepted him as the right father. They always wanted him to have some changes in them. So that is just a question of generation to generation. Basically, the ratio remains the same in case of parenting. Every child thinks his parents do not understand him in this specific age. But parents being calm, taking care of this age specifically, if they behave calmly, quietly and try and understand and accommodate their child by accompanying him at times, giving him an opportunity to take decisions, allowing him sometimes to do what he wants to do. So probably this may help you to avoid getting into a clash with your child. Your support in such situations, letting him play alone, doing some adventures on his own or exploring on his own, probably may encourage him. Last but not the least is appreciation. You will remember when your child was in the pre-primary school or third, fourth or fifth, you were appreciating him for the small things he did. Probably when he was in pre-primary sections, his every act was capable of getting appreciation from you. But as the child has grown up, you will see that your appreciation has reduced a lot. And because of this, the child at times feels ignored. This also helps you out if you start appreciating the child for the deeds that he is doing. Now, how to appreciate the child? Because if appreciation goes in a wrong way, the child becomes more adamant and egoistic. To avoid this, you need to appreciate the child in such a way that his skills and efforts are appreciated and he takes it positively. If your child has studied good in the exams, he has got good results, or if you think that his some habit has really helped him to score good, then you can appreciate that skill. if your child has scored good in the exam and you have observed that in recent a month or so he was studying every day early in the morning, or he has put up a habit of reading daily or doing revision daily, or in case if you have your child has scored good in some sport or some event, he has performed very well and you have seen him practicing regularly, you have seen him doing some physical activity regularly, maybe an exercise or so which has built up his stamina for the sport, then of course you can appreciate the child for the skills and the efforts that he has taken. You can appreciate the child saying that the habit that you have put on of daily workout is really work. You have made it and you are a great performer now. Or if he has scored good, you can say, I really appreciate the way you have studied in this 1 month, doing revisions every day, getting up early in the morning and studying on your own. We really feel very proud of you. Appreciating the skill encourages the child. The child feels appreciated and the child always is hungry for the appreciation. So for this appreciation, he will continue doing such things over the period of time. So parents, there is nothing to worry if your child is in teenage. Teenage is also one important phase of life which we have gone through and our children are also going through. So handle them with care, support them, help them explore. See if you can follow some tips which I have mentioned. This will definitely help you out and let your child explore the world. Thank you so much. If you have liked my insights, do like the video, share and subscribe. Thank you very much.